Hi students, good morning. Today we are going to learn the first lesson, history first lesson, the rise of nationalism in Europe. I have given already introduction for this lesson. So now we can learn the second topic, totally six topic in this lesson. First topic already we have completed. So now we are going to learn the second topic. The first topic, the French Revolution and the idea of the nation. Yes, how did the French Revolution, those who participated in the French Revolution, what are the important things in French Revolution, we have learned in the last lesson. So now we are going to learn the second topic of the first lesson. The second topic, the making of nationalism in Europe. What is that? The making of nationalism in Europe. The making of nationalism in Europe, we are going to learn now. If you look at the map of a mid-18th century Europe, you will find that there were no nation state as we know them today. When it happened, 18th century, if you are looking the because on the time, no nation state in Europe, after that only the nationalism in Europe happened. Because of that only they have mentioned this two line. What we know today as Germany, Italy and Switzerland. What is that? Today we are learning what is the Germany, Italy, Switzerland. They are the independent country divided into kingdom. But now divided into kingdom, duchies and cantons whose rulers had their autonomous territories. What is that? They are ruling themselves. Autonomous means they are ruling themselves. They are not controlled by any other, they are ruling themselves. In college also we are telling autonomous college. For example, Tiruchi Jamal Muhammad College, Abdul Kalam also studied there. Okay, for example only I have told you now. So next day, Eastern and Central Europe were under autocracy. What is that? East side and central side in Europe of Eastern Europe and Central Europe were under autocracy of monarchies within the territories of which lived diverse people. In the Eastern Europe and Central Europe, there are more languages spoken by the people. There are different people living there. They did not see themselves as sharing a collective identity or common culture. But in India, what we are doing, we are having some festivals. Because of the festival, we are organized. Okay, but here they are not having any cultural, common cultural activity because they are different religion, different caste and different people. Because of that, they are celebrating differently. So often they spoke different language. The people also not speaking same language. They are speaking different language and belonging to different ethnic group. The Habsburg Empire. Next day. This is the Eastern and Central Europe. Don't forget East side and Central Europe. Next one, the Habsburg Empire that ruled over Austria-Hungary, for example, was a patchwork of many different regions and peoples. It included Alpine region also. Habsburg Empire is in Austria-Hungary. It included first empire, Eastern and Central Europe. Second one, Habsburg Empire. Look at this. This is very important. Alpine region, Tyrol, Austria and southern land as well as Bohemia, where the aristocracy was predominantly German speaking. What is that? In this Habsburg Empire, what is that? Habsburg Empire mostly, predominantly means mainly. Okay, they are speaking Germany. They are speaking German. German. So, first one is Eastern and Central Europe. Second one, Habsburg Empire. Next included, it also included Italian. Yes, in it there are subdivisions are there. Included the Italian speaking provinces. Provinces means I already told you, Maganam, like state, Tamil Nadu. Okay, in British India we have 8 provinces. So only in the flag, 8 lotus they have mentioned. In second lesson we have learned. Okay, so Italian speaking provinces of Lombardy and Venetia, what is that? Venetia in Hungary, Half of the population spoke Magyar. What is that? In Hungary. These are one mark, ma. In this page is very, very important. Learn well. Okay, you want to read minimum 4 times this page as Magyar. While the other half of the spoken variety, local language, dialects means local language in Galicia, the aristocracy spoke Polish. The aristocratic people speak Polish language, Boland language. Okay, beside these three dominant groups, there are also lived within the boundaries of the empire a mass subject peasant people, Bohemians, Czechoslovakia, Slovaks to the north, Slovans in Carniola, Groats of the south, as north side who were living and south side who were living, and Romans to the east side in Transylvania. Such difference did not easily promote a sense of political unity. The only tie binding these diverse group together was common allegiance to the empire. Viswasam. What is that? மன்னருக்கெல்லாம் விசுவாசமாக இருக்காங்க. த பீப்புள் வேறு டிஃப்ரெண்ட். ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இந்தியா, வி கேன் டேக் இந்தியா. தெர் ஆர் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஸ்டேட்ஸ், டிஃப்ரெண்ட் லாங்குவேஜ், டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ரிலீஜியன், டிஃப்ரெண்ட் காஸ்ட்டு. தே ஆர் செலிப்ரேட்டிங் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஃபெஸ்டிவல்ஸு. பட் ஃபைனலி தே ஆர்கனைஸ்டு பை இந்தியன். வி ஆர் இந்தியன்ஸ், வி ஆர் இந்தியன், வி ஆர் அலிகன்ஸ் டு இந்தியா. ஸோ ஹவு டிட் த நேஷனலிசம் அண்ட் ஐடியா ஆஃப் நேஷன் ஸ்டேட் எமர்ஜ்? ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த செகண்ட், இந்த செகண்ட் டாபிக் 2.1, aristocracy people, how they are living, and the middle class people, how they are living. Okay, this is very important. 3 mark, important 3 mark. Socially and politically, a landed aristocracy was dominant class on the continent. What is that? Aristocracy, like first estate people, second estate people. What is that? First estate people, second estate people dominate the third estate people. But the population of first estate and second estate low, but third estate people high. But the so the aristocracy people are low. The number of this class were united by the common way of life that cut across the regional division. They owned estate and countryside. Okay, they are low, aristocratic people were low. But what they are doing, they are in the countryside, village side they are having. Okay, estate, for example, coffee estate, tea estate, they are having more estate in village side, and town side they are having houses, bungalows. Okay, so they spoke French for purpose of diplomacy and high society. Yes, the aristocracy people speaking French for secret language. Okay, their family, their friends, they will speak them only with the French language, because the local language, they know local language also. The local people don't want to know the secret of the aristocracy, so only they are using diplomacy, Raja Tandiram. Okay. Their families were often connected by ties of marriage. So they are the French, the aristocratic people marry another one aristocratic people only, not local people. The majority of the population was made up of the peasantry. What is that? Peasantry. To the west the bulk of land was farmed by tenants. So the aristocracy people having more land, they are giving the land to tenants, kutthavaiki vittranga, and a small owner, while eastern and central Europe pattern of the land holding was characterized by vast estate which were cultivated by serfs. So they are having more slave people. Serfs means a slave. Okay, they are having more slaves. With the help of slaves, they are doing the agriculture. In western and part of central, Europe, the growth of industrial production and trade meant growth of town and the emergence of commercial classes who existing was based on production of the market. So in the western part of the central Europe, there are more industrial, because of that more production was happen. Industrialization began in England in second half of the 18th century. What is that? England, second half of the 18th century. Second half of that means 1715. Above 1715. But in France, part of the German state occurred only in the 19th செஞ்சுரி. திஸ் இஸ் இந்த எயிட்டீன் செஞ்சுரி இன் இங்கிலாண்டு, எயிட்டீன் செஞ்சுரி இன் ஜெர்மன் அண்டு ஃப்ரான்ஸு, ஓன்லி நைன்டீன்த்து, வாட் இஸ் த 19th செஞ்சுரி. ஸோ நியூ சோஷியல் குரூப் கேம் இன் டு பீயிங் ஏ ஒர்க்கிங் கிளாஸ் பாப்புலேஷன் அண்ட் மிடில் கிளாஸ் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியலிஸ்ட், பிஸ்னஸ் மேன், ப்ரொஃபஷனல். எஸ் ஓகே. ஸோ இன் வேக் ஆஃப் நியூ சோஷியல் குரூப்பு, வாட் த மிடில் கிளாஸ் பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ மேக்கிங் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி இன் பிஸ்னஸ் அண்ட் ப்ரொஃபஷனல். மிடில் கிளாஸ் பீப்புள் ஆல்சோ பிகம் ஃபேமஸ் இன் சென்ட்ரல் அண்டு ஈஸ்டர்ன் யூரோப். தீஸ் குரூப் வேர் ஸ்மாலர் இன் நம்பர் டில் லேட் நைன்டீன்த் செஞ்சுரி. ஃபஸ்ட்டு வி ஹவ் லேர்ன் த எம்பரர்னோ எம்பையர் இன் இட். ஸோ சென்ட்ரல் அண்டு ஈஸ்டர்ன் யூரோப் ஆல்சோ குரூப் ஸ்மாலர் நம்பர் டில் த 19th செஞ்சுரி. இட் வாஸ் அமாங் த எஜுகேட்டட் லிபரல் மிடில் கிளாஸ் தட் ஐடியாஸ் ஆஃப் நேஷனல் யுனைட்டி ஃபாலோயிங் த அபாலிஷன் ஆஃப் அரிஸ்டோக்ராட்டிக் ப்ரிவிலேஜஸ். ஸோ வாட் தே ஆர் டூயிங், தே ஹவ் கேன்சல் த ப்ரிவிலேஜஸ், சலுகைகள், எல்லா சலுகையும் கேன்சல் பண்ணுறாங்க. ஓகே, பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட் த கெயின்டு பாப்புலாரிட்டி, பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தட் த கெயின்டு பாப்புலாரிட்டி. ஓகே, நெக்ஸ்ட் டாபிக், வாட் டிட் லிபரல் நேஷனலிசம் ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார், வாட் இஸ் மீன் பை லிபரலிசம், ஃப்ரீடம். ஓகே, வாட் இஸ் மீன் பை லிபரல், வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன். ஓகே, ஐடியா ஆஃப் நேஷனல் யுனைட்டி இன் ஏர்லி 19th செஞ்சுரி யூரோப் வேர் க்ளோஸ்லி அலைடு டு த ஐடியாலஜி ஆஃப் லிபரலிசம், வாட் தென் ஆல் த ஒன் நீடு லிபரலிசம். ஓகே, வாட் இஸ் மீன் பை லிபரலிசம், த டேர்ம் லிபரலிசம் டெரிவேட் ஓகே ட்ரைவ்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த லேட்டின் வேர்டு. ஓகே, லிபர், லிபர் மீன் ஃப்ரீ, வாட் தட் லேட்டின் வேர்டு லிபர் மீன் ஃப்ரீ. ஃபார் த நியூ மிடில் கிளாஸஸ் லிபரலிசம் ஸ்டூட் ஃபார் ஃப்ரீடம், த மிடில் கிளாஸ், ஃபார் த மிடில் கிளாஸ் பீப்புள் லிபரலிசம் மீன்ஸ் ஃப்ரீடம் ஃபார் த இண்டிவிஜுவல் அண்ட் ஈக்குவாலிட்டி ஆஃப் பிஃபோர் லா. தே நீடு, தே ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் ஈக்குவாலிட்டி பிஃபோர் லா இன் இண்டியன் லா ஆல்சோ, வாட் பிஃபோர் லா ஆல், பிஃபோர் த லா ஆல் ஆர் ஈக்குவல். ஸோ பொலிட்டிக்கலி இட் எம்பசைஸ்டு த கான்செப்ட் ஆஃப் கவர்மெண்ட் பை கன்சர்ன்ட், அட் த பெர்மிட், கன்சர்ன் மீன் பெர்மிட். ஸோ பொலிட்டிக்கலி இட் இஸ் அக்செப்டட் சின்ஸ் த ஃப்ரெஞ்சு ரெவல்யூஷன் லிபரலிசம் ஹேட் ஸ்டூட் ஃபார் எண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆட்டோக்ராசி. எஸ் அப் டு 1789 ஃப்ரெஞ்சு ரெவல்யூஷன், வாட் இஸ் மீன் பை லிபரலிசம், தே வாண்ட் டு கேன்சல் த மொனார்கி, தே நீட் ரிபப்ளிக், பட் நவ் தே நீட் ஃப்ரீடம் ஃப்ரம் ஆல், பிஃபோர் லா ஆல் ஆர் ஈக்குவல், நவ் பிஃபோர் லா ஆல் ஆர் ஈக்குவல். ஸோ ப்ரிவிலேஜஸ் கான்ஸ்டியூஷன் அண்டர் ரெப்ரசன்டேஷன் கவர்மெண்ட் த்ரூ த பார்லிமெண்ட் 19th செஞ்சுரி லிபரல்ஸ் ஆல்சோ ஸ்ட்ரெஸ்டு இன்வைலபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் ப்ரைவேட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி. ஓகே, ப்ரைவேட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஃபார் வி வாண்ட் டு கண்ட்ரோல் த ப்ரைவேட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி, வி வாண்ட் டு கண்ட்ரோல் த ப்ரைவேட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி தட் ஆல்சோ ஏட் ஈக்குவாலிட்டி பிஃபோர் த லா டிட் நாட் நெசசரி ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார் யூனிவர்சல் சஃப்ரேஜ். ஸோ ஈக்குவாலிட்டி தே ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் த ஓட்டிங் பவர், சஃப்ரேஜ் மீன்ஸு ஓட்டிங், ரைட் டு ஓட், ரைட் டு த ரைட் டு ஓட். ஸோ யூ வில் ரீகால் தட் இன் ரெவல்யூஷனரி ஃப்ரான்ஸ் விச் மார்க்ட் த ஃபஸ்ட் பொலிட்டிக்கல் எக்ஸ்பெரிமெண்ட் இன் லிபரல் டெமோக்ரஸி, த ரைட் டு ஓட் அண்ட் டு கெட் எலெக்டட் வாஸ் கிராண்டட் எக்ஸ்க்ளூசிவ்லி ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஓனிங் மேன். ஃபஸ்ட்டு தோஸ் ஆர் ஹேவிங் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி, தோஸ் ஆர் பேயிங் டேக்ஸ், ஃபார் தெம் ஒன்லி தே ஹவ் கிவன் த ஓட்டிங் பவர். மென் வித்தவுட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி அண்ட் ஆல் விமன் வேர் எக்ஸ்க்ளூடட் ஃப்ரம் த பொலிட்டிக்கல் ரைட்ஸ். எஸ் தோஸ் ஆர் நாட் ஹேவிங் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி அண்ட் விமன், ஃபார் தெம் தே ஆர் நாட் கிவிங் சஃப்ரேஜ். ஓகே, ஓட்டிங் பவர், தே ஆர் நாட் கிவிங் ஓட்டிங் பவர். ஒன்லி ஃபார் எ ப்ரீஃப் பீரியட் அண்டர் த ஜாகோபியன் டிட் ஆல் அடல்ட் மேல் என்ஜாயிங் சஃப்ரேஜ், ஒன்லி ஃபார் ப்ரீஃப் பீரியட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்மால் பீரியடு. ஓகே, இந்த ஸ்மால் பீரியடு ஆல் த மென் என்ஜாயிங் த ஓட்டிங் பவர். ஹவோவர் த நெப்போலியன் கோட் வென்ட் பேக் அண்ட் பேக் டு லிமிட்டட் சஃப்ரேஜ் அண்டு ரெடியூஸ்டு விமன் டு த ஸ்டேட்டஸ் ஆஃப் மைனர் சப்ஜெக்ட் டு த அத்தாரிட்டி ஆஃப் ஃபாதர்ஸ் அண்டு ஹஸ்பண்ட். ஸோ ஆன் த டைம் த ஃபீமேல்ஸ் ஃபிகர், ஓகே, த விமன் ஆர் நாட் ஹேவிங் மோர் பவர், தே டிபெண்ட் அப்பன் த ஃபாதர் அண்டு ஹஸ்பண்டு. த்ரூ அவுட் த 19th அண்டு ஏர்லி 20th செஞ்சுரி விமன் அண்டு நான் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டிடு மென் ஆர்கனைஸ்டு அப்போசிஷன் மூமெண்ட் டிமாண்டிங் ஈக்குவல் பொலிட்டிக்கல் ரைட்ஸு. ஸோ இந்த 19th செஞ்சுரி வாட் தே ஆர் டூயிங், தே ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் ஈக்குவல் ரைட்ஸ். ஸோ நாட் ஓன்லி அ ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி மேன் all men and women need equal rights. So in the economic sphere, liberalism stood for the freedom of market and abolition of state imposed restricted on the movement of goods and capital during the not only the equal rights, they need some abolition of taxes. Okay, they are giving more tax, collecting more taxes, so they want to reduce the tax. During the 19th century, this was a strong demand of emerging middle classes. Let us take the example of German-speaking region. In the first half of the 19th century, Napoleon administrative measure had created out of countless small principalities in conference of 39 states. So what they are doing in Europe, more or less 39 states are there, all the 39 states, they are using own currency, 39 currencies, they are making different taxes. So it is making difficult for the merchant, vyaparigal. So when they are moving toll booth, in toll gate we are paying some money in toll gate like that. So the merchant also, every toll gate they want to pay the tax. So each of these possessed its own currency and weighed and measure. Yes, all the 39 state having 39 currency. So a merchant traveling 1833 from Hamburg, yes, in 1833, if a merchant want to travel through A39 from Hamburg to Nuremberg to sell his goods, would have had passed through 11 customs, so 11 toll booth, toll gate. So in the 11 toll gate, he want to pay the money as barriers and pay custom duty of about 5%. How many percentage? 5%. If he is having 100 bundles of rice, he want to pay 5 bundle for first country, second 5 bundle for next country. So how can we sell, how can we get profit? It is difficult for the merchant. Duties were often levied according to the weight or measurement of goods. Okay, they are making as how many, 100 kg, yeah, you can give me 5 kg. Okay, they are asking. So as each region had its own system of weights and measures, this involved time consuming calculation. The measures of the cloth, for example, was L, which, for example, a person is taking a cloth, want to sell the cloth for 100 centimeter, for one meter, he want to give 54.7 centimeter, 54.7 centimeter cloth means, and over, yes, each and every state is taking different measurement. For example, first one 54.7, second one 55.1, third one 65.6, fourth one 53.5. so each and every state is getting different taxes. These are taxes. Okay, they will get the taxes by money or material, anyone. Such condition were revived, or then such condition were viewed as obstacles to economic exchange and growth by the new commercial classes, who argued for the creation of unified the economic territory, allowed unhindered movement of goods, people and capital. So all the 39 states people organized and leaders organized and they are discussing. In 1833, a custom union, Solvarian, was formed at the initiative of Prussia and joined by most of the German states. So in the meeting, maximum of the states joined, and the union abolished tariff barrier and reduced the number of currencies from 30 to 30. So totally 30 currency become 2 currency. So they have cancelled 28 currency. They have cancelled 28 currencies. Because of that, the creation of network of railway further stimulated mobility, harnessing economic interest to national unification. A way of economic nationalism strengthened the wider nationalist sentiment growing at the time. Because of this, okay, wider nationalism increased. The merchant also happy now. So now నెక్స్ట్ న్యూ కన్సర్వేటివ్ ఆఫ్టర్ 1815 కన్సర్వేటిజం. కన్సర్వేటిజం మీన్స్ దే ఆర్ ఆల్వేస్ స్పీకింగ్ అబౌట్ ఓల్డ్ మ్యాటర్స్. పళమైవాదం అంటే కన్సర్వేటిజం మీన్స్ పళమైవాదం. సో ద ఫాలోయింగ్ ద డెఫిట్ ఆఫ్ నెపోలియన్ 1815 వాట్ దట్ 1815 ఓన్లీ నెపోలియన్ డెఫిటెడ్ బై బ్రిటన్ రష్యా అండ్ బ్రుషియా. బ్రిటన్ రష్యా అండ్ బ్రుషియా ఆస్ట్రేలియా ఆస్ట్రేలియా నాట్ ఆస్ట్రియా ఓకే. సో కన్సర్వేటిజం బిలీవ్డ్ దట్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్డ్ ట్రెడిషన్ వాట్ దట్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్డ్ ట్రెడిషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ స్టేట్ అండ్ సొసైటీ లైక్ ద మొనార్కీ ద చర్చ్ సోషియల్ హైరార్చీస్ ప్రాపర్టీ అండ్ ద ఫ్యామిలీ షుడ్ బి ప్రిజర్వ్డ్ వాట్ దట్ దే వన్స్ అగైన్ ఓకే నౌ ఓన్లీ దే హ్యావ్ గాట్ ఫ్రీడమ్ రిపబ్లిక్ బట్ దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ వన్స్ అగైన్ మొనార్కీ మొనార్కీ పవర్ ద చర్చ్ పవర్ దే హ్యావ్ గివన్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ చర్చ్ దే హ్యావ్ గివన్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ మొనార్కీ ఓకే ఓల్డ్ థింగ్స్ దే ఆర్ గివింగ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ ఓల్డ్ థింగ్స్ మోస్ట్ కన్సర్వేటివ్స్ హౌఎవర్ డిడ్ నాట్ ప్రపోజ్ ఎ రిటర్న్ టు ద సొసైటీ ఆఫ్ ప్రీ రెవల్యూషనరీ డేస్ రాదర్ దే ఆర్ గోయింగ్ బ్యాక్ ఆఫ్ ప్రీ రెవల్యూషనరీ డేస్ రాదర్ దేర్ ఐ రియలైజ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద చేంజ్ ఇనిషియేటెడ్ బై ద నెపోలియన్ ఇనిషియేటెడ్ బై నెపోలియన్ దట్ మోడర్నైజేషన్ గుడ్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ స్ట్రెంగ్థన్ ట్రెడిషనల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ లైక్ ద మొనార్కీ. సో ఇన్ ద మొనార్కీ పీరియడ్ పీపుల్ వేర్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ దే హ్యావ్ కంట్రోల్డ్ బై ద కింగ్ సో ఆన్ ద టైమ్ ఆల్ ద పీపుల్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ బై వన్ ఓకే బట్ నౌ ఇన్ ద ఫ్రీడమ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రీడమ్ దే హ్యావ్ డైవర్స్ దే హ్యావ్ డైవర్స్ డిఫరెన్షియేట్ దే హ్యావ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఒపీనియన్ ఇట్ గుడ్ మేక్ స్టేట్ పవర్ మోర్ ఎఫెక్టివ్ స్ట్రాంగ్ ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ ఫాలోయింగ్ మోనార్కీ ద స్టేట్ బికమ్ స్ట్రాంగ్ ఎ మోడర్న్ ఆర్మీ అండ్ ఎఫిషియంట్ బ్యూరోక్రసీ అండ్ డైనమిక్ ఎకనామీ ద అబాలిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్యూడలిజం అండ్ సర్ఫ్డమ్ గుడ్ స్ట్రెంగ్థన్ ద ఆటోక్రాటిక్ మొనార్కీ ఆఫ్ యూరోప్. సో వాట్ దే డిడ్ ఇన్ ద ఫ్యూడలిజం నెపోలియన్ ఆల్సో క్యాన్సల్డ్ ద ప్రివిలేజెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ స్టేట్ అండ్ సెకండ్ స్టేట్ దే హెవ్ క్యాన్సల్డ్ ద ఫ్యూడలిజం నిల ప్రభుకుల రెండు నిలత వాంగి ఎస్ దే హెవ్ గివన్ ద పెసెంట్ ఓకే ఫార్మర్స్ అండ్ సర్ఫ్డమ్ స్లేవ్ సిస్టమ్ ఆల్సో క్యాన్సల్డ్ దిస్ మేక్ ద కంట్రీ స్ట్రాంగ్. సో 1815 రిప్రజెంటేటివ్ ఆఫ్ ద యూరోపియన్ పవర్ బ్రిటన్ వాట్ ఆర్ ద కంట్రీస్ డెఫిటెడ్ నెపోలియన్ బ్రిటన్ రష్యా బ్రుషియా అండ్ ఆస్ట్రియా హూ హెడ్ కలెక్టివ్లీ ఆల్ ద వన్ ఆర్గనైజ్ ఎల్లామే సేర్ందుటాంగ ఓకే ఆల్ ద వన్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ కలెక్టివ్లీ డెఫిటెడ్ నెపోలియన్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ ఎ సింగిల్ కంట్రీ ఫోర్ కంట్రీస్ ఆర్గనైజ్డ్ అండ్ డెఫిటెడ్ నెపోలియన్ మేట్ వియన్నా టు డ్రా అప్ సెటిల్మెంట్ ఫర్ యూరోప్. సో ద కాంగ్రెస్ వాజ్ హాస్టర్డ్ బై ద ఆస్ట్రియన్ ఛాన్సలర్ డ్యూక్ మెటానిచ్ ఎస్ గివన్ ద డాట్ వన్ టు మెటానిచ్ డ్యూక్ మెటానిచ్ ద డెలిగేట్స్ డ్రూ అప్ ద ట్రీటీ ఆఫ్ వియన్నా 1815 విత్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఆఫ్ అన్డూయింగ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద చేంజింగ్ దట్ హ్యాడ్ కమ్ అబౌట్ యూరోపియన్ డ్యూరింగ్ ద నెపోలియనిక్ వార్. సో ద బోర్బన్ డైనాసిటీ విచ్ హ్యాడ్ బీన్ డిపోజ్డ్ డ్యూరింగ్ ద ఫ్రెంచ్ రెవల్యూషన్ వాట్ దట్ ఇన్ 1789 ద బోర్బన్ కింగ్ లూయిస్ 16 వాస్ కిల్డ్ బై ద పీపుల్ సార్ నో డీథ్రోన్ అండ్ వన్స్ అగైన్ రోబోస్పియర్ రూల్డ్ క్యాన్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ రోబోస్పియర్ రూల్డ్ దెన్ నెపోలియన్ క్యాప్చర్డ్ ద కంట్రీ ఫైనలీ 1815 నెపోలియన్ ఆల్సో కిల్డ్ బై ద ఫోర్ కంట్రీస్ నవ్ వన్స్ అగైన్ రెవల్యూషన్. సో సిరీస్ ఆఫ్ స్టేట్ వేర్ సెటప్ ఇన్ ద బౌండరీస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రాన్స్ టు ప్రివెంట్ ఫ్రెంచ్ ఎక్స్పెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్యూచర్ ఫస్ట్ నెపోలియన్ క్యాన్సల్ ద బౌండరీస్ అండ్ దే ఆర్గనైజ్ ద కంట్రీస్ జాయిన్ ద కంట్రీస్ బట్ నౌ అగైన్ ద ఫ్రాన్స్ నీడ్ ద బౌండరీస్ దస్ ద కింగ్డమ్ ఆఫ్ నెదర్లాండ్ విచ్ ఇన్క్లూడెడ్ బెల్జియం వాజ్ సెటప్ ఇన్ ద నార్త్ అండ్ జెనోవా వాజ్ యాడెడ్ టు బిడ్మంట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద సిటీ ఇన్ ఇటలీ ఏ రీజియన్ ఆఫ్ నార్త్ వెస్ట్ ఇటలీ బిడ్మంట్. సో ఇన్ ద సౌత్ బిడ్మంట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద సౌత్ బ్రుషియా వాజ్ గివన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ న్యూ టెరిటోరీస్ ఇట్స్ వెస్టర్న్ ఫ్రంటియర్ వైల్ ఆస్ట్రియా గివ్ కంట్రోల్ ఆఫ్ నార్థన్ ఇటలీ. సో బ్రుషియా ఈస్ controlling west side. Austria was controlling north side of Italy. But German Confederation, 39 states that had been set up by Napoleon was left untouched. Okay, Napoleon set up 39 states of Germany that was not touched by anyone. So in the East Russia was given part of Poland. East Russia given part of Poland while Prussia was given portion of Saxony, large region. So the main intention was to restore the monarchies that had been overthrown by Napoleon and create a new conservative order of Europe. What that the aristocratic people, conservative people want to once again make the monarchy rule, like monarchy rule. So the conservative regime set up in 1850 were autocratic. Autocratic means monarchy. They did not tolerate criticism. Yes, always the people criticize anyone. We also scolding CM, PM, MP, MLA and everyone criticizing. He is not good, all the one doing something wrong. Okay, we are scolding. So like that, here also criticism means saying something about the government. So they did not tolerate the criticism and dissent and shout to curb activities that questioned the legitimacy of autocracy government. Most of them imposed a censorship law to control. So they are making some censorship and control the newspaper, books, plays, songs and reflected the idea of the liberty and freedom. What is that? So they are controlling the newspaper, everything. So the newspaper, book, plays, songs are not against the government. What is that? Conservative government. These are associated with the French Revolution. The memory of French Revolution nonetheless continued to inspire liberals. One of the major issues taken up by the liberal nationalist who criticized the new conservative order was freedom of the press. So what that they are asking, freedom for the press. Okay, final topic is the revolutionaries. What are the revolutionaries? Who are the revolutionaries? Yes, okay. So they are working for the people. So during the year of following 1815, the fear of repression drove many. Okay, so more the leaders oppress the people. Readers oppress the people because of that liberal nationalists underground. So secret societies. Okay, after 1815, three secret. How many secret societies? Three secret societies. So many secret societies are there, but mainly three sprang up in many European states to train revolutionaries and spread their ideas. To be revolutionary at this time meant a commitment to oppose monarchical form of had been established after Vienna Congress and fight for liberty and freedom. So the secret society people are opposing the idea of monarchy, opposing the idea of monarchy. They need freedom. They need freedom. Most of this revolutionary also saw the creation of national state as a necessary part of this struggle for freedom. Yes, they are fighting for the freedom of their country. One of the yes, who were the secret society people. Yes, but one of the important individual, one such individual was Italian revolutionary Giuseppe Mazzini. What is that? Giuseppe Mazzini. So born in Genoa in 1807, he became member of secret society of the Carbonari. This is one of the secret society name, Carbonari. As a young man of 24, Giuseppe Mazzini, 24 age, he was sent into exile in 1831 la avaru naadu kadathirranga, sent to another country for attempting revolution in Liguria. In the place of Liguria he attempted revolution. Because of that the government sent Giuseppe Mazzini to another country. So he subsequently founded two more underground society. First, not only one, another two underground secret society also there. First one, Young Italian Marseilles. Okay, Young Italian Marseille. And then Young European Bern. Young Europe in Bern, Young Italian Marseille. So totally three I told you. Three. whose members were like minted young men from Bolande. So these society people were not only in particular country, they are coming from Poland, France, Italy and German states. Yusuf Mazen believed that God had intended nation to be natural units of mankind. So God can organize all the people for the country. So Italy could not continue to be patchwork of small state and kingdom. It had to be forged into single unified republic within wider alienation nation. What then? He was thinking, what is that? All the people were organized by a single country. So following his model, secret societies were set up in Germany, France, Switzerland and Poland. So all the countries set up the secret society. Giuseppe Mazzini's relentless opposition to monarchy and his vision of democratic republic frightened the conservative. So conservative people fear about Yusuf Mazzini's secret society. Because of that, Metternich described him the most dangerous enemy of social order. So one of the conservative man, Metternich, say Yusuf Mazzini is the enemy of society. Okay, that's the second topic over. Read in book, take notes.